Well, boys, here you are.
Three veteran shiners are mashing in their signature shine recipes using ingredients they brought from home, bringing them one step closer to winning a jar of Popcorn Sutton's famous liquor.
5 minutes in, no burns or bloodshed yet.
Three experienced shiners are making their plain corn shine stand out with their own take on the classic moonshine flavor, apple pie. The winner of this challenge gets extra time in the final round, bringing them that much closer to winning one of the last jars of Popcorn Sutton's famous corn whiskey.
Hey, Josh.
Hey, buddy.
No bloodshed.
I got knives.
I know, I'm worried about that. I don't want to find no finger in my liquor.
That might change the flavor of it.
Oh, yeah, you got some fire in there.
I'm telling them boys, they're after it.
Did you get cinnamon sticks, Josh?
I got some bacons, but I don't see them. You know what? You swapped up on me. Where's my damn stuff at? Y'all see this?
I don't like it. Let me see it. I want to smell it, see what it smells like.
You can have all you want. All you got to do is ask.
I'd like to have me a couple of them, if you don't care.
You can have whatever you want, brother.
Same
That's
here.
Plenty. That's plenty. Anytime I ever do this, I always have more than an hour. Right now, I'm up against these guys. You know, Daniel already had a recipe. He knew what he was going to do. I didn't really have a recipe wrote down. I just knew how to throw it in here, and I'm just kind of doing it.
What you got there, Mark? Peppermint?
That's apple cider candy.
Apple cider candy?
Yep. Might help me, it might not. I don't know.
Daniel keeps pulling stuff from jar to jar over there. Is he mixing stuff in the jar?
I use light brown sugar, dark brown sugar, just a little bit of white sugar, and cinnamon, and just a little bit of nutmeg.
You know, Josh, he had the top jar. He just got to make sure he don't make up a big bucket of swill over there and just compliment it a little bit.
Every time I ever make apple pie, I put all this stuff in there, and when I'm done, it's overpowering. So I'm just kind of going at it light and easy, and then I can work my way to where I need to be.
That's probably a smart move.
I've made a lot of apple pie, but I'm in between two real strong competitors right here. But I'm gonna give it my all and see how good I can do on it.
20 minutes, boys.
Man, you got a flame over like a campfire.
Yeah, buddy. You can't sit around and wait on a slow burn on this. If we just got an hour, we gonna do it. I love a good fire. I don't care what I'm doing. I love to cook with fire.
When you're messing with cinnamon, you gotta be careful because there's a fine line between just enough and too much. Oh, God dang. What am I gonna do? I just dumped about a half a pound of damn cinnamon in this thing. How can I get that out of there? Oh. I hope them boys like that stuff, because it sure is strong.
Josh already got his jar on ice.
Okay, here we go.
All right, Mark getting ready to pull it in there. Look at that. Here we go. Man, strain fell in.
Mark, you want me to hold that for you?
Well, I'd appreciate it.
Well, I'm a coming.
Yee-haw! Just don't pull it on his hand.
Hell yeah.
I tell you, it smells good.
15 minutes, gentlemen.
Hey, Josh.
Hey, buddy.
I'm gonna go ahead and tell you a little secret.
What?
I believe we're already beat.
Because he put that candy in there?
Y'all might be at a tie.
Ain't none of us probably win.
That must be some dangerous stuff, Mark. You got both of them gloves on.
Yeah, Mark's a jarring.
Mark's a jarring his up over here in welding gloves. I don't know if I'm drag it or not.
I'm hot. I'm hot.
That's some dangerous stuff. You better go and cool that stuff down, Mark.
I know it. Yeah, I'm thinking on it.
I've got her on ice over here, boys.
Let it get good and cold and bring it to us. Boys, you got 5 minutes.
You put any liquor in it yet?
No liquor.
You ain't put no liquor in it yet? Mm.
The secret is putting the right amount of alcohol in this, sir.
3 minutes, brother.
Good deal.
That's the best I can do with what I had to work with.
All right.
With. I hope it's cool enough. I don't know if it is or not.
It is what it is.
I got faith in you, Mr.
Owens. I got all the faith in the world in you, brother.
Thank y'all.
Bring it in here, Margie. Guess I can do that.
Okay.
That's fair enough.
We'll come get you.
All righty, bud.
All right, Tim Smith, pour us up some.
Mr. Mark.
Kind of looks like Gatorade. Well, ain't no scorched liquor smell in here this time.
Well, he cleaned it up good.
It's hiding behind that cinnamon stick.
And all that candy put in it.
That candy was really good, though.
The only thing that I'm worried about is my scorched liquor. I was trying to kill the taste of that.
I still taste just a dab of the scorch, but not much. He's done excellent with it.
I think it's a little bit light on alcohol. I think he was scared of it because it scorched it. So he
think he'd be ready if he put more in it.
Scorch is going to be up front. Yeah. I'm going to give him really good marks for overcoming it.
Yeah, he dressed that up like he's going to church. Let's move on to Josh.
I don't get a lot of cinnamon.
I smell moonshine. A little bit of cinnamon. I'm tasting apple in there.
Getting good, strong apple in it.
Well, look, there's a bushel in there.
That's what I'm saying. I'm tasting all apple.
Yeah, and it's got some liquor
it's
in it.
It's got some horsepower.
Pretty tasty.
All right,
Here comes old Daniel. That smells really good, too. Now, Daniel's has got a lot of damn liquor in it.
Yeah, and a lot more nutmeg.
Yeah, I smell it, too. I don't smell none of my moonshine. He had the lowest proof.
Low.
Oh, that's good.
You know, you won the last time what they said by 140 proof. Well, I put a quart and a half of 180 in that, so he'd already kick your ass.
Yeah, you can taste the alcohol in that one.
I think Daniel reblended his jars
before he mixed them. He had some other high shots over there.
He did.
Boy, that'd work you over right quick.
Well, I really like Daniel.
Oh, judge, if you got to put these in order.
Welcome back, boys. Y'all all did a damn fine job. I'm gonna tell you that right off the bat. Marky, your liquor was fantastic. You overcome that scorch really good. They just barely a little hint of it in there. So you did a good job. That green apple candy that you was talking about, that really worked good in this. The downside of it, a little light on alcohol. Daniel, really good drink. You had plenty of liquor. We looked at it and thought, well, it's gonna have a lot of cinnamon. It did. That might be the downside. That might need more cinnamon, but had plenty of octane in it. That horsepower's there. Josh, I'm telling you, you're worried about that cinnamon. You don't need to worry about it. It's there. I mean, it's got plenty of cinnamon front to back. Complement that apple and that brown sugar. Good solid drink.
Thank you, brother.
Josh, put too many apples in it.
Supposed to taste apples, apple pie.
If you'd have put more alcohol in it.
There's about 140 proof I poured in there.
You should have put a little bit more. But I believe the apple sucked it out.
I don't think so. It ain't had a lot of time to suck the damn juice out yet. I just made it. Come on now.
Let me tell you what, ain't none of you going home. We're just going to name one winner here.
Boys, the winner of this run will get an extra 30 minutes to run their mash and make the best possible liquor they can.
With that being said, the decision here is Daniel, you're going to get the time. New other two guys, great job. And I advise you just drink the hell out of them all because they're good.